former Green MP Golriz Ghahraman will appear in court next week, charged with two counts of shoplifting. Now, Ghahraman's political career imploded as a result of the allegations, resigning after returning from an overseas trip. Now, she's apologised for her actions, citing mental health problems and work stress. So, we wanted to look at the impact of work pressure and how and why it can lead to extreme and risky behaviours. Well, here to discuss it all is Mental Health Foundation Chief Executive Shaun Robinson. Shaun, good morning.
Morena.
Morena. Look, mental health serious. It's very serious. We know that. But many people suffer from mental health problems. Many politicians suffer from them too. But we seem to only hear about it when MPs are being caught for bad behaviour. I feel like it's become, and I don't want to take the mickey out of mental health, but I feel like it's just become a PR tool to get out of a sticky situation. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I don't think so, actually. And, I think we've seen people like Todd Muller sort of talk about his mental health. Chloe Swarbrick
yes.
has talked about her mental health struggles. So, yeah, and I even think, particularly in the case of Ms. Ghahraman, she's talked about her mental health, but she hasn't said, let me off for my behaviour, you know, don't prosecute me for shoplifting because I was experiencing work stress and mental health issues. So, yeah, I live with bipolar disorder,
yes.
So I'm kind of managing ongoing mental health challenges throughout my life. I'm very clear that we should sort of do two things at once. I don't want to be held to a lower standard of behaviour because I live with bipolar. And I think, you know, people who are experiencing mental distress, that absolutely we should hold them to account for their behaviour. And our politicians just the same as anybody else. So Kerry Allen, Ms. Ghahraman, you know, they need to be accountable for what they've done. At the same time, we need to have compassion for people's mental distress and, you know, be seeking to make sure that they've got that support. It's not either or, it's both and. I mean, there will be times, you know, in workplaces or in any sort of part of life where some people may use their mental distress as a kind of attempt to sort of excuse themselves from bad behaviour
yes.
or poor performance at work or something like that. You know, that's a reality. People often do find all sorts of reasons to try and get out of those things, but we should not accept that.
But you would know the nature of the job to be a politician. We all know MPs work extremely hard. The nature of the job is working in this cooker pressure, long hours, public scrutiny. Why would someone with mental health want to enter into that? And who's to blame for not looking out for them? I mean, what are the flags there? And should there people be there to take them in and help them?
Sure. Well, look, you know, number one, everybody has mental health. So if we said, you know, nobody who might be subject to any sort of mental health challenges should be an MP, we'd have no MPs. Because, you know, experiencing times of mental distress, of pressure, that's just part of being human, you know. And the research will tell us that over 80% of us would experience a time that might be a diagnosable mental illness at some point in our lives. So, you know, that's number one. So therefore, Parliament, and in fact, any workplace, needs to try to ensure that it mitigates those kind of challenges to people's mental health as much as possible. And that's actually the law. It's actually part of the health and safety law that workplaces, and Parliament is a workplace, need to protect the mental and emotional well-being of their staff.
We have a new government. We had to talk about this just before, which means that we also have our new first ever mental health minister. What are you hoping to see? What are you hoping that they will help change or help make more aware of?
Yeah, look, I think, you know, Matt Ducey, who was our first ever minister of mental health, you know, he's got his own lived experience of mental distress when he was younger. He was a therapist, so he's got a lot of skin in the game. He spent a lot of time learning the sector and the portfolio while in opposition. I'm hopeful that we'll see some, you know, real tangible progress on the direction that the inquiry into mental health set. And, you know, that is very similar to what we need in in workplaces, you know. So that's three kind of things together. It's trying to minimise the things that do harm to people's mental health. It's trying to uplift the behaviours, the lifestyle, the kind of little habits that we can all do every day that build our resilience and our positive mental health. And then it's making sure that there are services and support for people when they're struggling. And it's those three things together that will improve our mental health.
Shaun Robinson, Mental Health Foundation Chief Executive. Always good to talk to you.
Thank you, Daniel. Thank you for coming in. Thank you.